What's up, guys? This is TheRiflemanUK, and I am back to bring the next episode of my Empire Total War Let's Play as the United States. So to run off where we left off, we have encircled the last of the Russian forces, and I expect there's going to be a great scattering once this battle's finished of troops running every possible direction. And but the hope is we can utterly destroy them. That is the plan, and this will be the last battle of the Russian Empire. The last meaningful battle of the Russian Empire. So let's get to it. It would be nice if this battle would be slightly unfulfilling because they got so many reinforcements face down raiding troops, because whatever cavalry we have we're going to want to keep back in order to defend against... Oh, nice wide open battlefield as well. It's delicious. So I want my guard artillery here with a nice big field of fire. Perfect. Another artillery unit probably here. We'll have another clear field of fire, probably further up. Maybe in front of the fence. Might limit their redeployment options, but I can deal with that. Then let's go threes. Well, I was about to say three might be too many. Actually, three's pretty good. Three fusiliers in the centre. There you go. Let's do two line infantry, one fusilier unit, one unit of guards in the trees. Republican guard in the trees. Grenadier, line, fusiliers in the trees on the right. Then our riflemen and scouts will... I'm not sure where they'll go. Probably on the right somewhere. I'll find space for them. Our indirect fire capabilities probably want to be spread out to provide complementing support. Infantry ready to rock and roll. We have no cavalry. Deploy. Yeah, they can fire. They can fire shrapnel shot. So are they. Good, we're doing a hell of a lot of damage to the artillery that's already inside the battlefield. So here's their first reinforcing army, and that's a bucket load of cavalry. You guys can deploy stakes, so you will deploy stakes. Artillery for now, concentrate on the last unit, full artillery, just because they're in range to fire shrapnel shot. Even though they're just firing round shot for now. Those near misses will do a lot of damage. Triple whammy there, you hit some three troops. Three troop types. Okay, now let's target them as we've got a bit more freedom. I probably want units to I want my howitzer units to target units at different ends of the battlefield so they have more like spread out targets to actually shoot at. Oh, and all these men are hidden. So Mr. Footline Infantry Unit does not know they are there. Notice they're just forming up a new line. There we go. We said, now Maitland, now's your time. And here they go. Cautious about deploying my riflemen, as so much cavalry into the field. Also, the general's bodyguard may be about to enter. Okay, this flank has been secured, or will be secured. So let's quick climb shot against the square formation. Yep, General is going to run into my rifle and scouts. A few fleeting shots, but not a whole lot of damage. Okay, now they're running in. They'll run into my second unit of rifle and scouts. Poor souls. Oh god. So this is my tempting target. Just run, just draw them in. Artillery is dropping in, doing gangbusters. This general's bodyguard. The general may die on another set of stakes. Yep. Turn my troops around. Oh no, these guys may not die. Rifle and scouts may suffer and die. However, that is a sacrifice I am willing to make. We'll mob them and we will see what we can do. Could send my general. Let's get him in. The square is going to hold firm on the flank. The entire Russian army is retreating in disarray. My gun has got charged. And more troops pour into the battlefield. So. Oh, wow! Well, I suppose they did take so much damage from the stakes. Get these riflemen back in. Square formation is... It broke. Form it again and you form it. This unit will remain stationary and will keep throwing in support from distance. To be honest, General's bodyguard might get a charge off on my men. So I'm going to limber up my artillery. Let's push. Scouts might be able to get another charge. It's another general's bodyguard. Everyone get ready. Everyone reload their rifles. Succession. The general's been shot out of the saddle once more. A few more will die to spikes. And they are done. Let's move up the riflemen. So these men will advance. You men will form square, because these are cuirassiers. You will move up. Now this is advance. I let you stay where you are, because you'll probably get shot to bits by my square formations if they get their muskets up. I want to charge one of these fusiliers, but they're going to get drawn into fighting with my squares. Chance remain firing square, plink at range, rockets will continue to do so. To be honest, actually, this might not be just a bad place to have my artillery just firing round shot. My howitzers can move up, but everyone else is probably not going to get super effective. Like, I'm not going to set up to fire shrapnel shot and such like. Because we are advancing up a hill. Especially as they want to drop quicklime on us. We want to advance up in rather short order. You hunt the Siberian hunters, everyone else carry on. Everyone else is carrying on. Everyone else get in formation because there's a cat's cavalry coming right after you. So who do you fancy? You aren't sure. Feel full now vogue of using light infantry in this game. They can be useful, but they end up more often than just being super vulnerable. Ooh, okay, you stop firing. I'll retreat my rifle and scout somewhere over here. Draw them into the to hit the square formation with their cavalry. Most of our trees will manage to escape. Let's get my artillery to fire up. Fusiliers form square on the flank. As soon as they hit the form square, they're in. These marines. Mob the horses, mob the cavalry, as they're feeling a bit delicate. Fusiliers feeling a bit peaky. If they can make the horsemen rout, that would be ideal. So foot guards and marines, they might tear this line of infantry position in two. Everyone's reloading like a madman. Yep, he says you're winning decisively, but plenty of your men are going to get pulled off their horses. Understandable, my fusiliers would be very unhappy. Quick plan failed to go off. Go after these five cavalrymen. Now they've got a bit of breathing space to run into a little tiny square. Okay, the Cossacks are coming in. And charged on the left. So let's get ready to commit. Ultimately, because you've got so many armies in response, Well, artillery's probably not doing it's probably doing more harm than good. So you, mate, just hold your fire. Like my foot artillery at least. All of you guys can't manage to kill. Foxy Light Horse unit. So this chap is going to come over here and be ready to set up my new line. We've been charged, we have been charged by Union Marines. Still haven't killed a silly horse unit. Okay, it's time for danger close. All my artillery engage this central combat. This is where they all are. This is where they can do maximum damage. There we go. Poor fusiliers. Just get out of there. So one of my friendly infantry is absolutely smashed. Well, this is what happens when you leave the gun line and you get greedy. Still, the more troops of mine that are out, the more replacement armies come in. It's not as if I'm running short of troops. Because they certainly are. Because that's your lot, I think. All the mortars are coming in. But not deployed at the same time, weirdly. Charge up to them. of course, the first unit that comes in. Do you want some artillery? No, I do not. Why are you... Look, I've sent... These guys are meant to be charging the Cossacks, but they're like... They're running away. This unit could do with routing, because it's not doing anything useful. You shoot with the House of Cavalry, you shoot this unit of Marines. Just my artillery holding the line. Although I should have a bunch just to start to get my good infantry units getting into position. Wait a minute, is it bringing just a bunch of different generals? Should have been smarter with what I bring in. She hit me as well. My generals will go after this weak unit. You are naught but weak Marines. Cool, wherever you're coming from, there should be more of these guys coming in. You smash into that line infantry. Zero problems risking the generals. They're just a 1,000-point unit. Okay, now you're going to be done. Shatter that foot unit. Lancers move out. Hit that foot line unit. The generals fall back. Oh, whisper. Rockets inbound. More artillery. Loads of damage to that. It's a very pretty collection of generals I'm building up. These guys are going to take forever to get into position. They will represent the core of my new line. My new army. There's a whole bunch of generals and lancers in the garret this unit. Oh god, what a friendly fire! And their artillery. Are they still bringing men in? Yeah, they are. So it is of value to me. It is of value to me to be aware of the fact that I do want units to be preserved. So my generals generals have admirably breathing space, while my lancers are they routed. Smash that unit of marines. I've got a big ragtag bunch of units that just aren't very useful. But we do have units capable of blowing holes in their troops. So this unit, you get out of here because you're not helpful. You get out of here because you're not helpful. If you even can, I think you're glitched to hell. You run, because I don't really need you. You run, because I don't really need you. You are in a good position. My guard are in quite a good position now, they've got their heavy horses to rip on the line. So you... prime candidate for some counter-battery... Shots go in. A whole bunch of shots land. A good amount of kills, so then all of my actual units that are engaged also need to get involved in counter battery fire. Everyone else has fallen short. Can you get involved if you got the legs? Just sure. Let's instead go after Gauntlet Infantry. Yeah, still not bringing more men in. I was going to say that might be it, but we'll soon find out. Okay, Guard, you need to focus fire this unit of Dragoons because they're after you. Run this infantry unit across. Oh no, they've lost half their number. Not sure how. Let's run my infantry across just in case. Although I think they should reload and fire. Ah, okay. No, they're protected. They're fine. Okay, you get back to counter battery. 24 pounders. More houses. You go away, because you're not useful. To be honest, General, you get out of here, because you're not useful. Most of you aren't, to be honest. Nor you. Nor you. You're a meat. 24 pounders might not. They might come up here. One round, so I do actually have what's firing. Okay, I'm going to want one howitzer. These chats are useful because they just provide so much firepower in one unit. They are sniping us from long range with their artillery, but there's not a lot we can do about that. I mean, bar shoot them, but You're not useful, go away. You're not useful, go away. Here's what we're interested in. He's about to load. You know, a lot of infantry do a lot of damage to one particular unit, but they have got a hell of an artillery park back here. Too much damage to it. It's mostly trailing teams and accompanying grenadier guard cavalry, but that's still useful to kill. You guys that are firing your own shot, you guys can fire. You guys may as well start firing up these guys as well. I'm conscious that I do have a time limit set to this. So I do need to push. But right now I've got such a ragtag army of artillerymen. More artillery, no, go away. Artillery is not what I need, game. I think I might have to try provoke them into attacking like so. And bring in... Okay, commit my dragoons to fight their dragoons. Seems like a good idea. Charge in. Actually engage them. Here comes more grenadier guards. They have left their artillery park unprotected to a certain degree. In which case then, grenadiers do a loop and run around. Well, avoiding the stakes, obviously. Keep running. Don't worry about if they shoot you. They're just light infantry guards. There we go. They're throwing in their final towel. Colonial light infantry. Oh, they do have a unit of grenadier guard dragoons. Quicklime's firing short, which is nice. My howitzers to start firing quicklime. I mean, if they're going to leave their guys unprotected, then that's smashing. I'll take that out. Ignore their dragoons, why are you running towards them? I mean, you're gonna get shot again, I accept, but... If you can reload and get over here, provoke someone else. think of this outcome. Drop my quicklime down on top of them. Four bodies. I think this was our high water mark. This is where we got up to. Okay, let's fall back. Our grenadiers will fall, but with this victory, we should begin to advance. Back to where we were. This infantry, if you wish to get involved, you'll probably have to run up to about here. They're using light infantry guards to shoot at my cavalry, which means they're probably also going to get their concern. Their cavalry's concerned they're under small arms fire, so they're also engaging friendly units. All of my artillery begin hitting that mortar battery. So many guns, foot artillery might actually do something. Still haven't done anything. I'm supposed to set my light infantry to go after them especially. You guys can begin to move up against that unit. Okay, those my horse guard units actually go after the line infantry guards to provide as much support as possible. At least it's nice to see the Russians didn't go out without giving somebody those in the meantime. Okay, form square. You also form square. Okay, infantry can engage the mortars. Formation is holding, and they're against guardsmen, so elite infantry are difficult to break. Particularly as another square stood right next to them. You guys push up. This artillery begins shooting at 146th Cossack Regiment. These guys can too. Who's that right at the back? Oh, routing artillery trains. So I think it's the final retreat. There we go. Phew, finally. Our 24 pounders are still withdrawn, quote unquote. Phew. That was a pretty good battle, and I think it was a good way to Pyrrhic. It's not really Pyrrhic, because we're about to, well, down the losses. They can't, because their faction is about to die. Yeah, see, they lost much more men than us, and their armies begin to scatter, and this is why I immediately just want to go and remove the faction, because chasing them down would be rather boring.
Yes, sir. Your orders. Make ready.
Replenishing. I could probably hit them again, but that was the climactic battle, I think. lots of traits were gained. All of my generals became got bonuses for that. Fighting against their fairly mediocre Russian opposition. But let's hop over to Ufa, where the final destruction of the Russian Empire will be done. But looking at the timer, I think it's time to end the part. So thanks for watching, guys. Hope you've enjoyed, and we'll see you next time for the final destruction of the Russian Empire. Cheers, guys.